Hi. Today's question is, my daughter is 30 years old and she has a polyp in her ovary and PCOD and she's unable to conceive. Is there any way that her polyp can go without any surgery? Now, the reason I'm answering this question is because this is a very common question these days, right? There's so many people who have difficulty in conceiving and polyps are common and polyps sometimes cause bleeding disorders or too much bleeding, and PCOD is not uncommon as well. And why are we getting all these problems? You know, all these are hormone related, and our body produces hormones, and all our hormones are orchestrated by the pituitary gland. It's a gland at the back of our brain, and it orchestrates all the hormones. Hormones are just, it's something that different organs produce which looks after various functions of the body. So we have reproductive hormones, but we also have cortisone, which handles our well-being, and thyroid and growth hormone and so many different hormones. And today we are facing a kind of hormonal havoc because we're upsetting this hormonal balance. Today I'm going to share with you two important factors to put this hormonal balance right. One of them is hormones that come into our body from outside. We get hormones in our body in all kinds of ways. One of them is through our food. Because if we're consuming dairy, milk, or milk products, that means butter, cheese, paneer, ice cream, curds, buttermilk, or anything that's made of milk, we are consuming hormones that the cow has in her milk naturally for her calf. It's a growth hormone as well as other hormones, and it's to make a baby calf grow to full size in a short period of time. It also makes us grow. Many of us are overweight. It also causes growths in the body, not just polyps, but even cancerous growths. And so it's really important to get these out of the way, you know. So dairy is one, but also other animal products. When we eat chickens, those broiler chickens are just 6 weeks old, but they are made to grow to full size, which normally takes 12 weeks, with the help of hormones. When we raise any animals these days, hormones are used. And when we consume animals or their products, we're getting back hormones which upset our own hormonal balance. So the first thing to remove is hormones from food. Also hormones in your medicine cabinet. Many times we are prescribed steroid hormones, or even oral contraceptives are hormones. So we should minimize the hormones that we are taking in. And then finally, chemicals. Chemicals are hormone disruptors. And there's a whole list of chemicals that we have in our lives now. We're literally swimming in chemicals. You know, the first list of chemicals are the personal care chemicals. The toothpaste and the shampoos and the soaps and the lotions and the potions, perfumes, deodorants, hair dyes, aftershave, shaving cream, all of these are chemicals. So that's number one. Then number two, medicines. Medicines are also chemicals, you know, and we should see how we can minimize our intake of chemicals that are medicines as well. And then three, the chemicals used in the home, that means the mosquito repellents, the pest control, the phenyls, the detergents, fabric softeners, all kinds of things are chemicals, and many of them are things that we don't need. Air fresheners, these are just chemicals. Sometimes you sit in a taxi and they have an air freshener out there, or you walk into a showroom or a hotel and there are automatic air fresheners. These are all hormone disruptors. And when we eat packaged food also has chemicals. And these are hormone disruptors as well. And then there's a third set of chemicals that we can do little about, and these are the environmental chemicals. But we can actually do something, because we are all adding to the environmental chemicals by using plastics or buying things that we don't need and then disposing of them. And this all adds to the junk in the world. And this ultimately finds its way back into the soil or into the sea, and then comes back to us through the water. So nowadays, you know, even the tap water has chemicals in it just because of the way we polluted our earth. And the municipality even adds chlorine to it, another chemical. So we're just literally swimming in a world of chemicals, and we can do our very best to minimize it by understanding that this is not the way nature meant for us to live. None of the animals on the planet appreciate swimming in chemicals, but we actually think that it's good. Hand sanitizers and so many things. So think about all the chemicals in your life and cut them out. And think about all the things which contain hormones and remove them too. And then many of these hormonal complaints will go. Of course, there are a few more things, and everyone should follow SHARAN lifestyle, which is a lifestyle that's as close to what nature meant us to eat as we can do coming from a regular lifestyle that everybody eats. Whatever we recommend is just stage one of health. But once you get to stage one of health, your body will guide you to stages 2, 3, and 4 until you experience perfect health. And that's something which is our birthright and everyone can experience. Wish you perfect health.